Hello, everybody. I'd like to thank you all for being here today, and thank you to all the students for preparing your pieces so carefully with the help of your teachers and for uploading them and so that we can present them today. Thank you to all your teachers who've continually provided their loving guidance, even in the face of the many obstacles we've faced this past year. And to thank you to all the parents and family members who continue to encourage you and support you in your musical education and endeavors. Now, perhaps more than ever, we've been made aware of just how vital a role music plays in our lives and how it can help bring us through the many difficulties of life. Throughout this time of isolation, music has brought many people together. We saw and heard the footage of the people in Italy hanging out their apartment windows. I hope you saw that. I saw that. Singing together in one accord, even though they were all sequestered under strict quarantine rules. And this was so uplifting to them and gave all of us hope. We saw a huge rise in the number of people who decided this was the time for them to take on learning to play an instrument, because they finally had time to devote to practice at home. And this would help them fill the lonely hours with something other than boredom. Music is a great healer, and we all know the effects that it's had in our own lives. We are here to celebrate that today and together. Before we begin, I also want to thank our audiovisual Zoom technician, Rebecca Marquardt, who will be controlling the flow of the program. We're so grateful to have her. And we are going to ask that each teacher please introduce your students, and students be prepared to say hello to all of us before your video is played. And as Rebecca was saying, let's do this to do our clapping. And if any of you just feel like you just have to, shout out a big woohoo at the end of a performance, feel free, unmute yourself at that point after the performance, but then mute yourself again so we don't have a lot of noise during somebody's comments, okay? Are there any questions before we get started?
I'm going to chime in and encourage people, if you want to leave your video on so we can see your faces during the recital, you are welcome to. But just remember, we can see what's happening in your video screen. So if you've got a lot of distractions going on in the background, feel free to stop video, whatever you're comfortable with. But we're all in this together. It's going to be great.
Great. So without any further ado, let's get started with our first performer, and Suzanne Lukather, you're up.
Well, welcome everybody. Lori, thank you for those wonderful comments. They really, echo, I think, what all of us are feeling. And I just want to say that what an honor it is to be a part of this community of colleagues. We've helped each other, sharing our resources and our moral support all the way through this pandemic. And I don't know how I would have made it without that. They say into your life a little rain must fall, but obviously the person that said that hadn't been through a pandemic experience. thank you is hardly enough to say to Lori, who has worked tirelessly this last year to create and maintain a platform to keep the music playing for all of us. So thank you, Lori, very much. Grace Kang, she is 7 years old, and she came into the studio as a student from China. And this is one of the pluses of technology, that we've been able to conduct our instruction on Zoom, and students have been able to benefit from that. She attends the American school in their community near Beijing, and her parents are both teachers. Her father is a university professor and her mother is a teacher. Even at her tender age, Grace takes many lessons. She takes piano, ballet, voice lessons, and tennis. Of course, tennis is a great mind-body exercise and relates very well to singing, but we've only worked on Zoom, and I'm continually grateful and surprised at how students can progress on Zoom. So for this first selection, this is early morning, and it is by Franz Joseph Haydn. We left out one of his words, Franz Joseph Haydn. And then When You Wish Upon a Star from Pinocchio. And I just think it's delightful that she can join us. The parents, however, are not joining us in real time, because I think it's about 2 o'clock in the morning there. So they'll see it on Facebook, or they'll see it, excuse me, on YouTube later. So just very happy to have Grace join us via video. Thank you, Grace. Thank you very much. Our next performer is Jaden Zing, and he's a piano student, and he's been taking lessons for 2 years. He's been taking lessons for 2 years, and the last year it's been via Zoom, and there he is. Hi.
There he is. Hi, Jaden.
Hi.
Shall we get a screenshot of you? Okay, let's do it.
Okay, let's do them.
Very nice.
Very nice.
Whoops, I'm getting an echo.
Okay.
So Jade and I met when they lived down here near Pasadena. And then with the pandemic, the family moved up to near Santa Cruz, to Felton. And what's lovely about that is they're in the Redwoods and they're also by the ocean. So Jaden gets to go out into nature and see nature, right, Jaden? You get to play outside. And you have a kitty named Jimbo, right? That's been your companion during the pandemic. Now you're going into third grade this year, this fall? You're going into third grade. That's great. At San Lorenzo Elementary.
At San Lorenzo Elementary.
So mom has homeschooled.
So mom has homeschooled.
I'm getting a terrible echo.
It's echoing back from Jaden. So I'm muting Jaden while he's not talking. But Jaden, okay. You're welcome to unmute if you want to say anything. All right.
So mom homeschooled Jaden. You had homeschool this year, and I have to be a shout out to mom. She was really helpful all during the Zoom lessons. She was the go-to person. She stayed with the lessons, and like Lori said, you have to thank. Oh, there she is. Hi, Chloe. She was right there troubleshooting everything in the lessons. And a big shout out to all the parents who helped out during this time while we're studying on Zoom. So there are three pieces that are on the program for Jaden. And what's so lovely is the first piece, called 72 Petals, was written by Jaden. He wrote this without being asked. He just said one day, I wrote this piece of music. And so we're excited that he's performing that along with the minuet, which you'll probably recognize, those of you who are pianos teachers, J.S. Bach, and then also another selection, Pirates at Sea. So without further ado, I'm so delighted you're both here, Mommy and Jaden, to join in with this lovely performance. Thank you. Thank you, Jaden. So our next performer is Katie Indow. Now, this is a little bit different. This is a little bit of an homage to our pandemic experience that we want to share with all of you today. Katie has been in the studio all of her secondary school years, and she's now a sophomore at Pasadena City College, where she's a member of the Select Madrigal Group. But she was one of the casualties of the pandemic. She was, her year was senior, no prom, no graduation, and the pandemic hit exactly after the dress rehearsal of her high school production of Newsies. So there was no performance. After all that work, there was no performance of Newsies. So she's kind of our poster child of the pandemic for our little event here. See, she has aspirations of becoming a choral director, and I frankly think she's going to be very good at it because she has all the research skills and all the musical skills to be very wonderful at that job. So I support her wholeheartedly in her aspirations. So in honor of this end of pandemic, was sharing her performance in the State of the Art Westerbeck Recital Hall on Pasadena City College campus, where she appeared as the soloist in this year's spring concert, complete with a face mask, singing with the face mask. So we get to see a little bit of what that was like for those singers who were going to participate no matter what as singers during the pandemic. This is Katie Endow, and she will be singing Getting to Know You from The King and I.
Hello, class. Welcome to your first day of Zoom. My name is Mrs. Frizzle. It's a very ancient saying, but a true and honest thought that if you become a teacher, by your pupils you'll be taught. As a teacher, I've been learning. You'll forgive me if I boast, but I've now become an expert on the subject I like most, getting to know you. Getting to know you, getting to know all about you. Getting to like you, getting to hope you like me.
Thank you very much, Katie. So that was a little taste of what we've all had to endure during this time. Lauren Knapp just graduated. Hi, there she is. Let's get a lovely picture of you, Lauren. All right. Thank you. So Lauren just graduated high school from Ramona Convent School in Alhambra, where she was salutatorian of her class. So in addition to her scholastic achievements, she also competes in cross country. And she says that there's a correlation between singing and running. That's great. So in her high school career, she's appeared in several productions, including the last one, which was Into the Woods, where she played Rapunzel with the long blonde hair. She's also an accomplished artist as well as a potter. And I lost her little illustration that I had brought here to, here it is. So she comes to her music, comes to her voice lessons with her worksheet, which they all get worksheets that outline what they're working on and practicing on. And she has these delightful little things she does when she passes in her worksheet. And this was a recent one that she passed in. Oh, we can't see it. Well, I guess we can a little bit. That little illustration she put with her worksheet. So all of these students, they're all so talented, not just with their music, but with other things as well. So she is determining which college to go to at this time. Have you made a decision? No, not yet. Okay. So in her first selection, which is Saban Crudele, we have an exercise we do in the studio, where if we're singing in a foreign language, part of the learning process is singing the transliteration of that in English, which means it's not the English version, it's the actual literal translation, which is funny exercise because it doesn't match up necessarily syllabically with the rhythm, but it is an interesting, very interesting exercise. So in this particular video, Lauren is singing that exercise, which if you listen real closely, you will hear what the English, what the words translate, and then she will sing it in Italian, Sabin Crudele. Thank you, Lauren, for doing that exercise for all of us.
So this song is from the diary entry of a 14-year-old girl from the 17th century. She's being a total drama queen about her first heartbreak, although this song is written by a man, because for some reason he thinks he knows what girls do after heartbreak. Whatever. For clarity's sake, we are going to sing this in English, so everybody's on the same page about how absurd this really is. So this song is at the beginning of the movie when she's dancing around in a forest in that very Disney way, and he hears her and shows up from behind a tree for some reason and starts singing with her. That's it.
I know you, I walked with you. I'm here to introduce the next performer, Jasmine Jaramillo. I believe she's online. And she's an aspiring singing actress. She has participated in many competitions over the years and done CM for several years. She just earned her senior medallion last year. And this year she just placed first in vocal in musical theater in her category and won a $100 scholarship check. And and she's at Cal State Fullerton. So she's gonna start her second year there for musical theater. And so we're excited to have her here today. And so the video is her singing Watch What Happens. Oh, she participated in a lot of her high school musical theater shows at Cerritos High School. Like Suzanne was saying, she also was impacted by COVID. She was in rehearsals for, oh goodness, I'm drawing a blank. She was in rehearsals for a show that she didn't get to finish. Do you want to jump in and say what it was?
Yes, it was Into the Woods.
Right. So, yes, and you were going to play Cinderella.
Yes, exactly. So that's unfortunate news, but now that we're getting back, I'm excited to see what new opportunities I had for all of us. So excited.
Yes, and she's been online doing productions through Cal State Fullerton this past year. So anyway, enjoy Jasmine singing Watch What Happens from Newsies.
Write what you know, so they say. All I know is I don't know what to write or the right way to write it. This is big, lady, don't screw it up. This is not some little vaudeville I'm reviewing. Poor little kids versus rich, greedy sourpusses, ha! It's a cinch, it can practically write itself, and let's pray it does. Cause as I may have mentioned, I have no clue what I'm doing. Am I insane? This is what I've been waiting for. Well, that was the screaming of 10 angry editors. A girl? It's a girl. How the hell is that even legal? Look, just go and get her. Not only that, there's a story behind the story. Thousands of children exploited, invisible. Speak up, take a stand, and there's someone to write about it. That's how things get better. Give life's little guy some ink, and when it dries, just watch what happens. Those kids will what happens. And who's there with her camera and her pen? As boys turn into men, they'll storm the gates and then just watch what happens when they do.
Picture a handsome, heroically charismatic, plain-spoken, no nothing skirt chasing talkie little son of a lie down with dogs, and you wake up with a raise and a promotion. So he's a flirt, a complete egomaniac. The fact is he's also the face of the strike. What a face, face the fact. It's a face that could save us all from sinking in the ocean. Like someone said, power tends to corrupt an absolute power. Wait, it corrupts absolutely. That is genius. But give me some time, I'll be twice as good as that. 6 months from never, just look around at the world we're inheriting, but think of the one we'll create. Their mistake is they got old. That is not a mistake we'll be making. No, sir, we'll stay on forever. Give those kids and me the brand new century and watch what happens. It's David and Goliath, do or die. The fight is on and I can't watch what happens. For all I know is nothing happens if you just give in. It can't be any worse than how it's been. And it just so happens that we just might win. So whatever happens, let's begin.
is Taryn here? I don't know if she's here.
I don't believe so.
Her friend came over unexpectedly. They went to get lunch. So she said she'll catch it on the recording, but okay. But I'm going to watch it.
Okay. Well, I will introduce her anyway. Taryn is.
There we go.
Oh, and her mom, that's Carrie, her mom, who's on. And thank you, Carrie. Her mom has just been wonderful and supportive. And she's there at the beginning of every lesson to make sure that she gets on. God bless her. Taryn is 15 and going on 30. And she is going into her sophomore year at Peninsula High School in Palos Verdes. She is a very active member of the musical theater community where she lives. And she has done many shows at the Norris Theater in Palos Verdes, along with her at her school. Everywhere she's gone to school, she's always been in musical theater. She also performs with a group called Song. Is she in varsity or junior varsity, Carrie?
She's in JV, yeah. Song is actually, it's more like a cheerleading thing rather than singing, so.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. It's called Song, but it's a cheerleading group. So it's more of a dance, a cheering group, right?
Yeah.
And Taryn, she's very athletic and she's a great dancer as well. And she loves to sing pop and musical theater styles. And she's won a lot of awards throughout the years at the NATS district and regional vocal competitions. And thanks to the magic of Skype and Zoom and FaceTime, she and I have been able to continue working together ever since I left California and moved to Florida 4 years ago. So I'm just really pleased that we've been able to continue working together. And
we are too, Lori.
And here is Taryn singing Driver's License.
License last week, just like we always talked about, cause you were so excited for me to finally drive up to your house. But today I drove through the suburbs crying cause you weren't around. And you're probably with that blonde girl who always made me doubt. She's so much older. Everything I'm insecure about, yet today I drove through the suburbs. Cause how could I ever love someone else? And I know we weren't perfect, but I've never felt this way for no one. And I just can't imagine how you could be so. Guess you didn't mean what you wrote in that song about me. Cause you said forever, now I drive alone past your street. And all my friends are tired of hearing how much I miss you, but I kind of feel sorry for them, cause they'll never know you the way that I do. Yet today I drove through the suburbs, pictured I was driving home to you. And I know we weren't perfect, but I've never felt this way for no one. Oh, and I just can't imagine how you could be so okay now that I'm gone. I guess you didn't mean what you wrote in that song. 'Cause you said forever, now I drive alone past your street. Yeah, you said forever, now I drive alone past your street.
All right, I am going to introduce the next person. Now for something completely different. Alina Kang is a talented musician. She plays piano and she's studied with me for 6 or 7 years. And she's participated through the years in many competitions, recitals through our MTAC branch. And she's also done CM. She's finished CM level 6 and we're slowly progressing up, working towards level 9 now. She's taken a couple of years off, but she also builds robots and she plays cello, plays in an orchestra, is quite busy with her academics. And so anyway, she is playing Mozart Sonata number 10, K330, the first part of the first movement. And so, Alina, do you want to say anything?
I think that pretty much sums it up, yeah.
All right, great. And what orchestra do you play with?
The South Coast Youth Symphony Orchestra, so SCYSO.
Great, yeah, I attended one of their concerts a couple of years ago before COVID hit, and they're just incredible. They're an incredible group of young musicians, so she's doing a lot of wonderful things with her music. So, great, enjoy.
Thank you.
Our next performer is Isabella Bonfante. Oh, there you are, and don't you look lovely? I'm just going to get a quick screenshot of you, and then we'll go on. And if you will unmute yourself and chime in, because you can probably fill in a few details of what I would like to say. So Bella and I met each other right at the pandemic. So she's just been a student on Zoom. And I have to say, our work on Zoom gave me great courage during the pandemic, because she just kept getting better and better and better. And I was so delighted with her progress. So she's going into her senior year at Flint Ridge Prep in La Cañada. And she just finished a year of working with the choir at Flint Ridge and doing quite a bit of virtual choir work. Isn't that correct?
Yes.
Yeah. But what was so wonderful to be able to participate in and watch on Zoom was their spring concert called Always Something Sings. And it was kind of an homage to the pandemic. I mean, I thought it was beautifully put together, and the shining point of it, of course, being her teacher, was her solo in Quanta Qualia by Patrick Hawes, in which she sang a high sustained D. So it was quite a wonderful experience. Yes, it was quite wonderful. We just approached it like, well, Bella, this is what we call warp speed learning your vocal technique. And she addressed it, and she did the work, and she was wonderful. And in the actual image, when the choir was singing, they put her up in the top of the screen on top of a rainbow. So it was very appropriate. So anyway, today she's going to sing One Perfect Moment, which I think that was kind of one perfect moment. And it's very age appropriate. And I'm delighted you're here with your dad and mom. Or is your mom here as well?
It's all around.
Everybody's here. Okay.
My grandparents and my aunt are on here too.
Excellent. Well, please enjoy Bella Bonfante singing One Perfect Moment from Bring It On.
Inside.
That was wonderful, Isabella. Is Greta here? There she is. Hi, Greta. So Greta Cox is 20 years old, and she's going into her sophomore year at the Hart School of Performing Arts at University of Hartford in Connecticut, and where she's studying to earn her Bachelor of Fine Arts. And she's she's also taken advantage of technology, and she's stayed in California while she studied, studied from home via Zoom, I suppose. And Greta, you were a graduate of Peninsula High School, right? In Palos Verdes?
Yes. Yes.
So, and she was also very active in the musical theater program there, as well as at the Norris Theater in Palos Verdes. That's when she and I met each other. And she started studying with me back when I was living in California. And in addition to her acting and singing, Greta is quite an accomplished dancer as well. And so we refer to that as being a triple threat, and Greta definitely fits that bill. So I have a feeling that when she finally graduates and gets out there into the world, we are going to be seeing and hearing a lot from her. So I can't wait for that day, but I'm also excited for you to hear what she's going to sing today. So Greta, take it away.
Isabel Balderrama just completed her fresh person year at Louisville High School in Los Angeles, where she participated, like so many that we've had today, in fall drama and tennis clinics and in dance concerts. Outside of school, she began riding horses in English style
And she and I began comparing the strength needed to hug a horse in English style with your legs in because of the need to support in singing. So we're starting to hear about different things that help us keep our technical skills or build them and then keep them together. So horseback riding has been a big help there. Isabel's also sung for 3 years with the National Children's Chorus, where she's currently a member of the Premier Ensemble. As a member of the chorus, she toured South Korea and Japan in the summer of 2019. And so she's really looking forward to getting back to in-person singing like a few of the rest of us. So keep your fingers crossed about that, because the National Children's Chorus will tour Europe in the summer of 2022. And in the meantime, the National Children's Chorus is beginning a new program of a week-long opera camp this summer. So she has a few things to look forward to here. So, Isabel, if you would like to say anything before you run your lyric skis.
I'm not sure I have anything to add. I hope you all enjoy lyric skis.
I want to welcome everybody, and I want to thank Lori Moran Music, congratulate everybody who's part of this, the parents, the teachers, the friends that support all of this. This is our second virtual, and before I introduce Jacqueline, I just want to thank all of the parents and everybody who's supported it, as well as some of these. I'm hearing an echo like Suzanne was maybe to be not the interviewer. It might be under the performance. Let me hear that. Oh, that's, well, I'm still hearing an echo. But anyway, I want to introduce Jacqueline. She's 15 years old. She attends Beverly Hills High School. She has done 4 different recitals with me over the years and 1 virtual. When she came to me, her father had introduced her, and he had said she really has a talent, but he said it was hard for her to read music. And since she's been my student, you will be very shocked to see what she's done. She was I'm so proud of her. She was recently accepted to the LACHSA, which is equivalent to the High School of Performing Arts in New York for Los Angeles. She'll be attending there next year. There's only 150 people worldwide that are selected out of the thousands who apply. Her hobbies are friends, movies, playing tennis. And I just am so grateful. I was not one of the students that loved to practice like Jacqueline does. She puts everything into it. It's amazing to see somebody just so dedicated to what they do and love it and maybe eventually want to do it. And she's going to be performing Chopin's Waltz in E minor. So again, also thanking Rebecca, who makes this job look pretty easy, which it's not. This is a really big production for all of us to do. So thank you for your support and everybody else here today.
Brett, excuse me, just a moment. Jacqueline, could you bring the camera so your face is in the center of the screen? So I took one shot there. That would be much easier. Thank you, sweetie. Let me just take this. Nope, one more. One more.
What?
Okay.
Perfect.
Okay.
And I played this piece when I was 17. She's playing it at 15. Oof. So congratulations.
Hi, Kelly.
Hello.
This is Kelly Kudlik, and Kelly is 19, and she's going into her junior year at Cal State Fullerton. She is working toward her Bachelor of Fine Arts degree in musical theater. Kelly came to me when she was 13 or 14, I believe, she had been singing mostly classical music since she was in elementary school when she came to me. And she really had the basics of a wonderful vocal technique already developed. So my job was really made so much easier. And it was up to me to help her discover her mix and her belt voice and to learn how to sing the pop and musical theater styles. And while she loves singing her pop and theater songs, you should know that this girl can still bust a move on an aria or an art song. So I'm happy to say she has not lost those classical chops. And we've discovered through the time together that she has some coloratura range. She floats up to clear up to an F6 with purity and clarity and agility. So I have distinct feeling that Callie is going to be able to write her own ticket when she decides what she wants to do. So I'm very proud of her and very happy to have her sing for you today. And so, Kelly, take it away.
Said I was found by the side of a road. There were tracks all around. It had recently snowed. In the darkness and cold, with the wind in the trees, a girl with no name and no memories but these. Rain against a window, sheets upon a bed, terrifying nurses whispering overhead. Call the child Anya, give the child a hat. I don't know a thing before that. Traveling the back road, sleeping in the wood, taking what I needed, working when I could, keeping up my courage.
I know them. So we are taking a snapshot. Smile.
I have to put you in another view here. Just a moment, please.
Okay.
There you are, Nolan. I'm just going to take a snap of you. Thank you.
So my student Nolan Brown, and I'm very proud to be his piano teacher for all over 11 years, has just graduated from the high school, congratulations, being one of the best achievers in all academic disciplines, sports and music. Over the years, taking part in school symphony orchestra and jazz band as an accomplished pianist and bass player. Nolan also received several times the highest achievement certificates and cups as my piano student from Junior Festival, annual event of the National Federation of the Music Clubs. Now he's heading to Redland University College to continue his studies and his growth as a multi-talented, beautiful human being. Good luck in pursuing any career in your life. And my biggest gratitude to his parents and to whole family of very intelligent and highly educated people for giving Nolan the opportunity to study music over the years, learn to love, understand, and compose his own music in any style, folk, pop, jazz, and especially classical, the foundation of it all, even though he will not become a professional musician, but he could, believe me. You will hear now the proof. Prelude in B flat major, opus 23, number 2, by Rachmaninoff, played by Nolan Brown. Thank you.
That was fabulous.
Yeah, fantastic.
So worth the wait. Thank you all for being here and for sharing your talents with us. And once again, thanks to all the teachers, all the parents, and all of you students. And just keep doing what you're doing. And believe me, this is not going to be the last virtual recital we have. We're getting better at this. Every time we do it, it just gets a little bit better. So we're going to keep doing it and hope to see you all back here again very soon.
Oh, we did.
This is because of Lori Moran.
No, it's all of you guys.
Lori. Yes, Lori.
I'm really thrilled to be in your company. So
thank you.